alliance with ICA actually started in Abu Dhabi on the other side of the globe. I met one of their international specialists, Dr. Cheney St. Martin, and we immediately bonded because we seen the synergy of what ICA was trying to accomplish and then what also Gardenpool had to offer as far as solution goes. So in particular with ICA, we are designing and building with our own hands resilient farm systems, resilient to the effects of climate change, that are very productive, utilizing the latest technology. The effects of climate change aren't a death sentence. You know, we have all of the technology at our fingertips at this point. It's a matter of going through implementation now. So the one good thing I could see out of the hurricanes that we've had is that governments, the world governments, want to build back better. They want to invest into the future of technology to save their people. As far as making what makes a Gardenpool system resilient, one of our climate smart farms, for example, the system we built in Barbuda and also in St. Kitts and Nevis, it's a vertical system. So in 1 meter, we have 6 rows, okay? And then we have 6 more on top of that and 6 more on top of that. So vertical. It recycles the water using 98% less water. So if we have a drought that rolls around, the farmer with this system will have crops when everybody else does not. If we have problems with saltwater intrusion coming, this system is immune to that, whereas the other farmers are not. If we have a hurricane coming, most importantly, you could actually pick up those rows of gardens, set them aside in a structure, let the storm pass by, the next day you can put them back up, and you'll be the only farmer left with any crops whatsoever. And what that does is strengthen food security. It's very exciting to do this. So we're going to start in the Caribbean. I could see us South America, Latin America, spreading all throughout, on into the Eastern Hemisphere as well.